You looking beautiful. Looks like we still got a few more folks on the way for church, but I'm glad y'all made it here on time. You know, thank you, Wes, for this moment, because I got tired of, you know, talking to myself in public without a microphone. So, you know, thank you for being here. I finally get somebody to talk to. I just be sitting and smoking and talking to myself sometimes. I'd be like, man, I fucking hate spiders. And I just be looking around and shit, and I get scared, and then I start checking my pockets. I hate spiders so much, it's like, I hate spiders worse than white people. Some of them hate black people. You know how that shit gets sometimes. That's how bad I hate spiders. That's why I'm gonna kill them. I'm gonna kill them as soon as I see them. I know racism's bad. I'm sorry, I don't want y'all to feel bad. I hate it too. But sometimes I do like reverse racism, I can't even lie. One day I was sitting in a community, and I was in a car, and I saw this perfect opportunity. I saw a gentleman who was a Hasidic Jew, and he's just walking, you know, he's having a good day, it's beautiful, it's sunny and all that shit. And I'm just sitting there, and I'm looking at him. I was like, yo, every time I walk past a car, and there's a white person in it, you know what they do. Black people, you know what they do. They hit the lock. Yeah, it's like, oh shit. Just got unsafe. You know, that's happened to me a handful of times. So I was like, I see this man, and I was like, he's looking at me as he's walking. So I'm like, you know what? Boop. Either way, you should have seen his face, because he's like, did this just happen? Like, I hope I never won his name. Either way, fuck him. It was good either way. So I produced some animations. ChannelSUG.com. You should check them out. Me and my best friends, we try our best. But I didn't know that once you start pursuing your dreams in life, and especially when you're doing animations and cartoons, I didn't know you'd actually become a cartoon yourself. It's crazy. Like, I've been wearing this outfit for like the last 7 days, so if you see me at my last show, it's the same shit. But either way, I get to work on time, and that's all good. But one way or the other, it's like crazy. I somehow, you know, I'm not famous, obviously, but somehow I started a rap beef with a 50-year-old up-and-coming breast cancer survivor. It was kind of hilarious. Like, I work for this guy who's a fashion icon in his own right, and shout out to Ty Chan and Chad Senior, wherever Chad Senior is. Give it up for Wes. He just got cast in a new project. Yeah. It's gonna be cool. Look out for Call Me. But either way, this lady, you know, she didn't quite fit the look. But she got mad and told my boss's adversaries that he hired a homeless person.
Oh.
Yeah, but you know, people are mean. I don't know what it is about New York, but people become assholes. Because I'm the homeless person that she's talking about. So granted, I did just tell you I was wearing the same clothes for 7 days, but you know, I got an apartment on that shit. Either way, anybody have a crazy job or work with crazy people? Woo, give it up. What do you do back there? Teach, damn, okay. Yeah. In New York?
Yeah.
Whew, I pray for you. Anybody else? Anybody else got a crazy job? Oh, okay, all right, that's cool. Well, I got a job as a case manager, right? And, you know, social service can be really interesting. I'm not sure who's crazy between the people I work with and the people I work for. We house people with certain issues like drug issues and HIV and shit like that. And it's crazy dealing with the crackhead sometimes. It's always funny. Like, I got this one client, he always acts like I don't know he smokes crack. He's like, Satan came to my door. I'm like, what? Satan came to your door? I'm not even asking you for your rent yet. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to tell me what's going on. But he's like, yeah, man, them goddamn Percocets. I'm like, Percocets? I don't read your files, man. I know everything that's going on here. But either way, I walked into this one lady's house one morning. It's like 9 o'clock. I get there. She got a motherfucking candle lit on the table. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? I'm like, it's 9 o'clock. She's talking about, I just woke up. I'm like, you just woke up and the first thing you did was lit a candle? I'm like, what the fuck are you thinking about? Either way, I stepped into her kitchen area. I see a pair of panties on the chair. I'm like, is she trying to live out a fantasy right now? I was like, are you serious, ma'am? I don't want AIDS on purpose. I was like, you know, when it comes up to that shit, I know your files too. You can't hide this shit. Undetectable don't mean that shit. It don't mean that you're cured. I'm sorry, ma'am. It's like, thank you for trying, but next time, if you're going to do this shit, don't leave out random panties. Like, who the fuck wants to see that? That's where the Charlie Sheen part came in. Yeah, he helped quite a few of our clients. Speaking of, it's like, what's up with those hookers? It's like, did you really devalue your coochie that much? And like cut your career in half by accepting a few extra $1,000 from Charlie Sheen? Like, when you're a hooker, you gotta think about longevity in the game. You can't be thinking short term, you gotta think long term. But either way, you know, I smoke a little too much weed at times, and I got a little bit of time left, but I attract the strangest people sometimes when I'm smoking, like my neighbor. She's an early developing cat lady. And she like sits outside and she's just like, we're chilling, and she just starts rocking back and forth. I'm like, what the fuck's going on with her? And she like startles and like, she's like pointing at cats and kids talking to dogs. I'm like, all right, calm down, just hit this door, it'll be cool, it's gonna be cool, it's sunny outside. But she's not even the worst one. I got this other lady, she's possibly the saddest person on our block. We were talking about laughing and shit. Then she just starts crying. I'm like, the fuck is going on upstairs? Like, I don't never hear nobody crying or you know, see the police. I'm like, well, she must be getting tortured up there. She fucking all outside smoking my morning spliff. She's outside, right? She don't even say hello this morning. She just goes off into the little handicap ramp. The little handicap ramp area, right? Just did something real special. She just got down and was just doing this shit. I was like, is she trying to give me a goddamn mating signal? Or is she really going through some special shit right now? But either way, show love to people. Be kind to each other. Thank you for your time. I appreciate you all. Have a great day. My name is Darryn Smith.
Let's keep it going with Darryn Smith. You guys have fun so far?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I like to hear that. I like to see that. Keep